Action at a distance. That's a physics term that implies that something at point A can affect something else at point B without any obvious physical means to do that. Now, the physical means that we have come up with is a thing called field equations. A field equation, say if A is a charge that's fixed and can't move, but B is a charge that can move, then if A suddenly occurs, then a little time later, B will be pulled toward it because two charges attract each other. And the field equation predicts the force that that second charge at B will feel. Okay, but the thing here to think about is that the field equation predicts a result at a particular time and a particular point in space. Predicting a result is not the same as causing a result. When action at a distance first became an idea, that's when field equations became an idea, many physicists didn't like it because they didn't like this thing that you can't smell it, you can't feel it, you can't see it kind of fields. They just seemed to work, but they were non-material. They were just mathematical, and they didn't like that. Well, there's good reason not to like that. It actually doesn't work that way. There are no fields. In a virtual reality, things are computed. You don't need fields. Fields are superfluous. The cause, remember we said that fields only predict, they don't cause. The cause is a virtual reality computing the value of that force for the charge at B. So the field is a way to pretend that a physical process is going on and that the field is a physical process. Actually, the field is just a mathematical equation. The process is that virtual reality will specify values at points in space. So that force value is simply computed, as is its delay from when the charge at A first appears. So we don't need action at a distance to be field-based. It isn't. It's information-based. That's the nature of a virtual reality.